I love my job. I wake up every day and I'm excited to go into work. It's such a privilege to be able to do science for a living. Even after a decade, give or take, I'm still surprised that I get paid to do this every day. I think something that's often overlooked when we talk about science and scientists doing it is the human aspect. I think people are doing science with a wide range of motivations and goals. And we're much more used to talking about the scientific implications of our data than we are about the fundamental why of what we work on and how we chose that topic. Like many scientists, I've gotten excited about topics all across biology, from basic cell division in bacteria, to the life cycle of parasites, to how our cells respond to viral infection. Given that I'm able to get excited about these diverse topics, I think it's a fair question. How is it that I chose what I ultimately work on? For a very long time, from when I was maybe 10 until halfway through college, I was convinced that I would go into medicine. Being a physician was the way that I knew you could be connected to biology and also be directly helping people. And it was because of medical school applications that I began doing research in the first place. And along the way, I found accidentally that I loved research. I loved the people I was surrounded with. I loved the academic freedom I was given. And I even loved the constant experimental troubleshooting and failures that science required. But what really sealed my fate was the first time that I discovered something unexpected, something new. It's a feeling unlike anything else I've ever experienced, to know something that no one else has ever known before, ever. And I think that's a feeling that many scientists spend their careers chasing. In college, I worked for more than 3 years in a basic bacteriology lab, trying to understand how the model bacterium E. coli balances cell division and genome replication. And it was challenging work, and it was fun, and it was creative, and I felt selfish doing it. For such a long time, I'd had this very clear goal of helping people directly as a physician. And I remember very vividly feeling like I would have to choose between what I found personally fulfilling and what I was good at, and what would actually have a direct positive impact on the world. In retrospect, I think I just had a very siloed view of what basic research is and how basic science connects to the rest of medicine and to human health in general. In college, I was very fortunate to take a parasitology class that really shifted my idea of what research could be and has shaped what I work on ever since. There's a diverse range of bacterial, viral, and parasitic pathogens, from roundworms to dengue fever, that receive comparatively little research funding and scientific attention relative to diseases like malaria or HIV. Sometimes referred to as neglected tropical diseases, these are diseases whose burden is predominantly placed upon groups of people that are already disadvantaged or marginalized. These are diseases of poverty. These are diseases which can be deadly but are more frequently debilitating. And these are diseases whose effects are centered in areas with pre-existing public health challenges, like limited infrastructure, active conflicts, and other ongoing repercussions of colonialism. For me, studying the organisms that cause these diseases is how I can contribute to the fight for global health equity. As a postdoctoral fellow in Jan Koret's lab at Stanford, I'm trying to understand how our cells respond to the viral infections they are constantly being exposed to. Every cell in our body has the remarkable ability to detect and fight against viral infection using a cellular self-defense system activated by small signaling molecules called interferons. Interferons stimulate expression of some hundreds to thousands of genes, but we don't really understand what the majority of these genes are actually doing. My research focuses on understanding how interferon signaling is stimulated by viral infection and on trying to identify what individual interferon-stimulated genes actually do. By inactivating or overexpressing hundreds of defensive genes simultaneously, I can identify genes which have protective or deleterious effects on cell survival in the context of viral infection. I hope that my work helps broaden our understanding of this central immune signaling pathway, and hopefully will lead to novel antiviral therapies in the future. The relevance of my research to human health is something that's very important to me. I strongly believe in a shared intrinsic responsibility to change the world for the better, to improve the human condition in some way. And ultimately, that is why I work on what I work on. I am trying to better understand the basic biology of disease-causing microorganisms in an effort to improve human health, and I'm having a good time doing so.